I was asleep.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's now. Good evening, everyone, or good afternoon, I guess. Good morning for those on the West Coast. This is FWA Nitro. We're a little late on our broadcasting, but here we go. Our first match is going to be a one-on-one with Dashing Doug and Cheryl Smith. I'm going to be in the corner of Dashing Doug, as he's my father. Oh, something's gonna happen. Charles Smith is gonna do something. Well, there's no spot for me to be, so I guess he took away the manager or something. Anyways, this is Nitro, and this is Doug's. They've got a little rivalry going here. They've taken the belt from each other last few or three times. Belt's not on the line tonight. This is a little bit of retribution for Dashing Doug. Share this. Mobile live dashboard. Oh. Here comes the FWA World Men's Television
Contest is
Champion.
scheduled for one fall.
Okay.
Making his way to the ring, representing the way from Baltimore, Maryland, weighing in at 237 pounds, the AWA Television Champion,
Charles
Smith.
So everybody can get in on the group. Way. I don't know if anybody else has it. Let's go in the way. Come on. They literally have week each week. They take it from each other. That's why this match has been supposed to be a non-title match. Let the title stand somewhere for at least a week.
And his opponent from Canada, weighing in at 228 pounds, Dashing Doug.
He is not here to play tonight. Charles is the first to pop out at Doug. But Doug, using his experience, comes back. But Charles with the powerbomb. If Doug wins this match, he will have rights to one more shot. Charles is trying to put him out quick, though. Charles trying to choke him out. Doug is way too savvy for that. They tell everybody that he, all around, he's the oldest man in our company, but he still hangs with the young ones. Charles showing off there. That's all that was, just Tittle showing off. Where the pen is? Doug springboards in. He could have missed that, but he didn't. He hit Charles right in the face of that drop kick. Going out Charles, reeled it off. Doug is trying to use the long game here. Boys, the way is in action tonight. Well, they were, might be. They were in action at that pay-per-view where they lost their title. Oh, Jesus, I thought that was a three count. That referee was pretty close. Oh, there's a down to Doug. He just hit the ring clipper. And it's all over for Junie. Oh, what's going on here? Ooh, Junie knocks out, or Charles knocks out the referee. Charles showing some anger there. They're probably going to have to fine him. So, Doug won. Find. Probably going to fine him $5,000 for hitting the ref. Can't believe he hit the ref like that. Next we have Ray Rue and she's got her across the face. Jane against Alexi. Jane comes in quick. She puts her off the ropes. Which of these girls are going to pop up to the top? They've all been hanging around the mid-card. Jane running to the ropes. She sees that Alexi just ready to get down. Who is that? It is Ray Rue. They changed who it was supposed to be. It was supposed to be Jane versus Alexa. And now we got the who it is now. Ray Rue is not prepared to have this battle, apparently. We didn't even get notification that it was happening. So Jane just wanted to fight anybody. She didn't give a shit who came out. Alright. Since you were here, you're gonna go into the match. Ray Rue's trying to stay on the outside. She's trying to collect her wits. Jane's not allowing her, but Ray Rue, she's past that. Jane flies in with head scissors. Goes in. Oh, she breaks the count. She really wants to fight Raver on the inside. Raver, she didn't even want him in the ring. She wasn't even scheduled for the match. She was supposed to have the night off. Oh, she's going back in the ring now. Oh, but Jane caught her. Raver drops down, leapfrog. Whatever she planned, it didn't happen. Yeah, for a moment, we'll see what I mean. Try to have a little nap. I don't know when he's gonna do the whole thing. Jane just running back and forth. And Jane picks up the win over Raven.
Here is your winner, Jane Cruz Wildcats.
Your next match, folks, gonna be a battle of the girl tag teams when Bunny Bombshell and Akali goes in against, it was supposed to be a tag team, but I guess it's gonna be Michelle for against Akali. I don't know how it got changed, but we get to see how Michelle does on her own today. Both ladies have been coming up in the ranks of the FWA, all hanging around the mid-card. Can one of them break through and challenge Sam for the world title? Or whoever got the TV title now. I don't think it's Jenna.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making her way to the ring, representing Absolution from New York.
Bet you must have been in a dirty mood to get home. She looks pretty cranky. In the ring.
Representing the Trailblazers.
I can
from
never
the
say
west
this
side,
girl's name.
The Dragon, Akane.
Akali.
That's right. Yeah! Go get him!
I'm definitely expecting a tag team match. I don't know what's going on here. Both women walk to the center. Kylie hits with the first right hand, and lifts Michelle down around. She usually got red suplex. Kylie throwing Michelle around. At the moment, hits the leg. Michelle's got to get out. She's got to get away from Kylie's speed. A drop kick to the head. Oh, but Michelle did. That was it. She had taken enough of those. She poked over. Right to the head. She's ready for her when she gets up. Get her up on her shoulders. Kylie. Elbows. She gets out of it. Michelle kicks to the stomach. Right here off to the rope. Michelle throws her outside. What she got? Oh, she's running the ropes. Oh, and she hits with a drop kick through the rope. And Michelle pops down. Hits her with some right. Kicks to the ribs. Grabs a collie, goes back in the ring. There's Michelle. She does not want to get victories, count out victories, stuff like that. She wants the definitive pinfalls and submissions in the ring. Oh, that was a definitive kick to the head. What's the collie doing? She's pointing her out. Kylie picked the wrong way. Wrong time to float. Not able to run their ropes. Oh, she hit the DDT this time that she tried a second ago. She has to keep Michelle off her feet if she wants to get this match. She's dragging her. She wanted her near the ropes either. Kylie dragging Michelle around. Oh, I thought she had her. She had her in place for this. Oh, now maybe she's in place. Good job for the pin. Only a one count. Michelle not allowing her even to get the two count. Oh, she slams her on her face again. Michelle's getting out. Michelle is pissed off. She's slamming on her face. She's back with a couple right body punches, left body punch. She's run back. Oh, and she hits the Superman punch. Got her arms trapped. And she's just laying the boots to her. What's she setting up for? Oh, the TKO. Is that enough? Oh, a collie kick out. Michelle right back on her though. Up on the second rope. Ooh. Oh, she hit it in. Anyway, she hit the Kinshasa from the middle rope. Well, that's not. Kyle is going to keep my corner though. Michelle winds her up and hits her with a huge clothesline. She pops to the outside. That was amazing. Hurricane Rana very almost into a pin. Stay back. Push with the rolling stunner again. She's trying to drag her away from the ropes. And she gets the win over the shell. These two girls are not done. They're still fighting. Kylie trying to prove that she's the last woman standing. Next match, folks. This team, Los Boricas, has been tormenting the Tribe for weeks. The tribe has been trying to get number one championship contendership. They want to face the champions. But the Los Boricas keep standing right in their way. They've been sharing wins all through the countryside. Let's see what happens tonight.
The following is a tag team match set for one fall. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 419 pounds, Los Boricuas!
Here's Mexico all the way up. They had to hop on a red eye last night to get here. That sounded a little different, folks. I'm just a little stoned and a little tired. Probably should have said the tires first, right? And none of the other. If you can make it through, if it gets really, really quiet and for a full match, chances are I fell asleep.
And their opponents at a combined weight of 494 pounds. The Tribe!
And then you shut off your feeds, or you want to sit there and listen to me sleeping. I'm just warning you now. Back to the matches. We see Joe coming in. Oh, he's pointing at Los Boricas. He didn't like what they did to him and his partner last week. Against steel chairs. Matt's going to start off with Silverlink using his speed, dropping Matt off. Ooh, but Matt, oh, I thought Matt was using power, but no. Ooh, Silverlink's going to get in. The man hits a Lupe's press on. That's going to get down the tag. His tribal leader, Joe. Joe gets caught. He's a man. Joe keeps pushing him. So when it's time to realize he's going to deal with a weight disadvantage now. He uses his advantage. He just does lots of ropes. Like a junior weight, but he ain't no junior weight. Thank you. Michael, or Silver Mason, recently, both men have not given up much of a fight, but it looks like Matt getting his teeth. Last week they held a chair and they beat Matt right in the head with it. Ooh, what a reversal that was. Matt didn't see that one coming at all. So this is just a little reversal tonight. On him. That's his kick. That's your kick. I don't know what the kick's called yet. He hasn't named it. So Joe, if you're watching this, you need to know what the name of your kick and what the name of your move that Got it. That was sweet. That comes in with a big head scissors working on him. He points at Matt, but Matt grabs him. You can say that. So in the back drinking. And Billy Jack were having a drinking meeting earlier. Thank you. close to Gary. Gary takes a shot. Takes him off the injury.
Thank you.
back. I can see these fools are still battling in the way. This must have been one hell of a tag team matchup. Double draw kick. That needs to go get a tag. Go. Oh, he feels his spear. Joe knows about that spear. He's right in the shade now. Joe's gonna watch if they don't grab him. On the other side and knock him out. Oh, is Matt finally going to tag out? He puts up Gunko. Oh, Matt finally has a tag out. He holds him so Joe can get a couple shots. Across the ring. Joe showing him, getting that retribution for what he did to his partner. And then Joe goes back to the tag, which makes no sense whatsoever. I know Matt has a finisher, but Matt needed to heal some. For him. Didn't work. Matt was trying something. Ended up getting the first DDT put on him. Matt rolls out. He's smart. He knows he can't be pinned out there. But at the same time, he can have a high risk move put on him. He's doing a whirlwind all over the place. Matt doesn't know which way he's coming or going. Because his partner was coming down, he ended up going to hit the stairs. Matt's flying out. He's going over. Silver takes the finger. Silver makes Matt. Oh, that's hitting the Germans. Well, Junko, he's going. Oh, slam. Matt takes ball. Jay's here to save Matt, though. Dropkick. And then tag, he's at 0-10. Oh, he hits Matt with the spear. Again, that's way too close. Now he's going to figure out what he's going to do with Joe. Joe's now in the middle. can come in. Yes, he is. Well, I don't know what happened here. Leslie B and Killer and Willie J versus Mike Owens. Oh, thank good.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Jurosi Billy Jack, representing Damage Control from New York. Weighing in at 210 pounds, the Legend Killer, Willie Jack.
Twin brothers just starting back in here. I thought they won the tag team titles on Sunday, but I smoked way too much weed. I don't remember anything.
And his opponent, representing the Way from New York, weighing in at 269 pounds, Mike Owens.
This was really interesting, folks. It was a 2-on-2 match. Where is Junior Danielson? Does he get Willie Jack out of it? No, Willie Jack can win. Oh, he hits his knee. And Willie Jack gets the pin. What's happening here? Willie Jack on the outside hands Willie Jack a steel chair. Willie Jack takes his wrap out. Oh, there's Jimmy Danielson. Where did he come from? He wasn't there for his partner. Grab that mat, but he was there to help his partner with the chair. Willie Jack and Willie Jack are going to have to try another night. Final match, folks, is the U.S. Television Champion versus how did this happen? It was supposed to be Charlotte. She wants to attack the sheriff. The people stop changing the match on me on the fly. Ooh, Charlotte. Facing her, but she still has some involvement in the match. She should be appreciating the fact that Charlotte gave her a layup on this match. Shoulders. She should know from her actions, from Charlotte's matches with him and every other woman, that she should be doing that. And they'll come back and be respectful. In fact, she's hit that disaster kick. And just hit the back. Thank you. advantage. Showing maybe championship match in the near future. Until then, have a ball.